What are the social responsibilities of entrepreneurs? This answer is going to be somewhat controversial, but here goes. I believe that the best-run companies balance just four things, not five or six, just four. It's the interests of the shareholders, employees, customers, and suppliers, but not necessarily in that order. I've written about it many times and I concluded this after looking at a lot of companies. If a customer is balancing those four things well, true social responsibility is a natural byproduct. Keep in mind, just the term, social responsibilities, can be manipulated to be in favor of causes that don't necessarily benefit everyone. I don't believe in socialism and it's failed everywhere it's tried, so I don't regard that as being socially responsible. I don't believe in meaningless slogans or phony social causes. I believe the heavy lifting of community benefit comes from the individuals doing the work. No phony company slogan is ever going to do anything for anyone. It's a belief that intentions matter more than results. Not in the real world. I believe in building a company around the responsibilities of the individual and not someone else. I don't believe in getting someone else to do work I should be doing on my own. In fact, the people who tell others what they should be doing have a tendency to need the most personal work. It all still comes back to the careful balance of just those four things no matter how I look at it. I've spent decades thinking about how this all works, observing other companies, those I admire and companies I dislike. In all cases, when companies, for example, do intentional harm to the environment, they are not balancing those four things, are they? Yet, when a company runs at optimum and produces a good product customers love, provides decent returns to shareholders and pays people well, with happy suppliers, all of those interests now have the means to improve the world, right? Companies that behave badly in any way eventually get discovered for the real harm they cause. Shareholders do care about that stuff, and so do employees. You will always have a few who will look the other way for a paycheck, but for the most part, if the CEO is thinking about those four things, they end up with a very good corporate citizen. Look at it another way. How in the world does a failing company help anyone? Isn't that when they are most likely to cut corners and cause real harm to everyone? Unless you're actively doing something other than telling people what to do, you're in the pile of posers who talk a good game but never actually accomplish anything to make the world a better place. The people who do the most yelling are just under the delusion they did something meaningful when they didn't. My advice, go out and build a great company that improves people's lives. What is social responsibility, SR? SR is an ethical theory in which individuals are accountable for actions that must benefit the whole of society. SR involves honesty, integrity, care for the environment and proper care for workers including safety and health, consumers providing honest and accurate information as well as caring for consumers' welfare and the environment e.g. What happens to a product at the end of its useful life? Authorities in Brazil were appalled by producers of low-energy light bulbs stating that their product was good for the environment without even bothering to consider disposal after use. The local community, there must be a reasonable balance with the company's economics. If this equilibrium is maintained, then SR is accomplished. SR has become a critical part of the organization's overall performance and its ability to continue operating effectively. Probably the biggest impact of this on entrepreneurs is what I understood from Shushi's answer, paying it forward, as responsibility for one's wider sphere of influence. SR means not only being responsible for one's own behavior so e.g. What happens in practice is big corporates will be risk-averse and unfortunately the little guy tends to bear the brunt. I was doing some research and tried an example which I think clearly illustrates this problem. In Shell's annual report they stated they will not do business with organizations that don't meet their business principles and published in their report an example they meant what they said with what appeared to be a little guy, whose SR wasn't up to scratch and had been blacklisted. The report happened to coincide with the infamous President Robert Mugabe's finance minister Simba Mikoni begging for food aid while Mugabe was buying a brand new Mercedes motorcade. His personal car alone was the most expensive in the world and the money he spent would have been enough to buy staple corn to feed the whole nation for 3 years. Needless to say, when I asked Shell if they had blacklisted Mercedes as in supplying this motorcade to Mugabe, they clearly didn't meet Shell's stated business principles. I did not receive a satisfactory reply. Entrepreneurs are ripe for integrating social responsibility into their business. The Schwab Foundation for Social Entrepreneurship describes the common traits of ESRs that mirror the characteristics of a business entrepreneur. 1. An unwavering belief in the innate capacity of all people to contribute meaningfully to economic and social development. 2. A driving passion to make that happen. 3. A practical but innovative stance to a social problem, often using market principles and forces, coupled with dogged determination, that allows them to break away from constraints imposed by ideology or field of discipline, and pushes them to take risks that others wouldn't dare. 4. A zeal to measure and monitor their impact. Entrepreneurs have high standards, particularly in relation to their own organization's efforts and in response to the communities with which they engage. Data, both quantitative and qualitative, are their key tools, guiding continuous feedback and improvement. 5. A healthy impatience. Social entrepreneurs cannot sit back and wait for change to happen, they are the change drivers.